How do I take this limit? I thought to use L'Hopital's rule at first. It didn't work. I asked AI, which did it with Taylor series in approximations, but we are not supposed to know Taylor series in this unit. Let's have a look. Here we are going to compute the limit as x approaching 0 of this thing. First, if we put 0 into the x here and also the x here, we will get 0 over 0, which is indeterminate, meaning we will have to do more work in order to figure out the answer. But don't use L'Hopital's rule, because when you take the derivative like twice, you don't want to do it anymore. So how do we do this though? Here is the key. When we have the limit as x approaching 0, if you see sine and also like x on the bottom, here we are going to be utilizing the limit. In general, we have some input. I'm just going to call that theta. If it's approaching 0, and then if we have sine of theta over theta, then this is going to give us 1. And for this limit, please do not use L'Hopital's rule either, because even though we have 0 over 0, if you use L'Hopital's rule for this though, you will run into a circular reasoning situation, which is bad. But anyways though, I will just be taking this as a fact. We'll be using that. This is a very standard limit in your calculus 1 class. So to make this happen, notice that we have sine to the first power. So let's fix the power here first. On the bottom, we also have like 100, which is 10 times 10. I'm going to kind of like factor out the 10th power. This is what I mean. We will have the limit as x approaching 0. And then let's look at this as sine of 2 sine 10th power of 3x over just x to the 10th power, because I will raise this to the 10th power here. So I still have the same thing. Now, in order for us to utilize this limit, we will have to make sure the input here matches with the input on the bottom. I know we have x to the 10th power, but don't worry. We can use the limit lot to kind of break it apart later on. Right now, our goal is to actually just introduce this thing on the bottom so we can use that. And of course, this thing is approaching 0 as x approaching 0. So we will get the following. We still have the limit as x approaching 0. I'm just going to multiply this term on the top and also on the bottom. Let's put that down first right here. 2 sine to the 10 of 3x times this original sine of 2 sine 10th power 3x, like so. And then all over, here we have x to the 10. I'll put it here. But again, we will also have to have this thing on the bottom so that it's like multiplying by 1, right? So 2 sine to the 10 of 3x. And of course, I haven't forgotten the 10th power. I will put it here, right? But we can use one of the limit laws, which says the limit of something to the 10th power is the limit of this first and then the 10th power. So I can actually put this whole thing to the 10th power, because the 10th power is a continuous function. We can just do a limit of the inside first. Next, notice now here the input matches with this denominator, and then we have a product of this thing times this thing by another limit law, which says the limit of a product is a product of a limit. What it means is that we can actually take the limit of this by itself and then take the limit of this by itself and multiply them, provided both limits exist. They do, so we can do that. So if you just look at this portion in blue and take the limit as x approaching 0, since this and that, you can just make a quick substitution, say that to be theta. As x approaching 0, this quantity right here is approaching 0, so we can use this limit, so the blue part will give us just 1. Very nice, right? So we can proceed. Here is the deal though. Notice later on we have the sine to the 10th power and also x to the 10th power. We are going to do pretty much the same thing again, but the 2 right here on the inside does not have the 10th power. So I'm going to take care of that first. 2 to the 10th power is just a constant multiple. I'm going to put it on the outside. So that is going to be right here now. And then we have this thing, which is the limit as x approaching 0. And then we have the sine to the 10th power of 3x over x to the 10th power. And then times 1, which of course doesn't matter. And then raise this to the 10th power, like that. And of course, for the 10th power, I'm going to do the same thing. And this time, I'm just going to rewrite it for you guys. I need more space though, so much better. So here, this is 2 to the 10th power times, let's do the limit as x approaching 0. Here, we need a sine of 3x, and then just x. And then I will put the 10th power here, but we can do the same thing over the earlier. So let's put the 10th power right here. And then we still have this 10th power. I'm not ignoring the 1, it's just the 1 doesn't matter when you multiply. Anyways, now this input and the denominator should match, right? We have just a 3, it's okay. Let's just multiply right here and also multiply by right here so they match. So here we can take the 3x as our theta like earlier. So this portion becomes just 1. So perhaps I will do this right here again for you guys. And now we just have 3 to the 10th power. So all in all, here we have 2 to the 10th power. And then this is 3. Now do this in blue, I guess. This 3. Okay, this 3 and this 3 in blue. Much better. To the 10th power and then another 10th power, right? So it's 10 times 10, which is 100. It's a very big number. Don't multiply it out. This is okay.